Hello everyone, it's been quite a while since I last post our tutorial na ginagamit natin sa ating AutoCAD. Again, this is Coach Gene of Drafting Lifestyle and welcome to our channel. On screen, as you can see, this is a sample of a picture ng footing column. In structural foundation details or structural details, it is very important that you have to know the basic function of a footing column, as this is a very important and vital structural member sa isang structural plan or sa isang structure, bahay ba, building, restaurant, hotels, or etc. So, ano nga bang footing column? Footing column, these structural members are solely responsible on the strength and durability for walls and weight of the structure. So, in this picture, nasa baba ang ating footing. This is submerged sa lupa. At even, it has a measurement kung ilang ang distance niya sa baba galing sa lupa papuntang pababa. Okay? And what is a footing? Footing is an enlargement at the lower level end of the wall. Pier or column is distribute the load. Column to distribute the load into the ground. So in other words, this is submerged sa baba ng lupa para malaman natin, para may i-distribute ang weight ng lupa, weight ng structure sa lupa. Now, soil testing is very important when you are going to draft or before you are going to draft ng footing column detail. Kasi minsan, ang lupa hindi pare-pareho. If ni river, iba ang klase ng lupa. If sa palayan or sa mga rice fields, iba rin ang klase ng lupa. Sa upper high hill, iba rin klase ng lupa. So that's the reason why you have to conduct for soil testing. But in purposes of illustration and instructions only for high school students, I'm going to teach you how to draft the footing column detail. Of course, when you're going to scale it into higher scale, 1:20. Next thing you have to remember, column, a vertical structural member that supports the weight and strength of the house or the building. So in other words, ito ang column. Okay? So, yan ang ituturo ko sa inyo kung paano siya i-drop sa AutoCAD detail. Okay? Sa AutoCAD drawing. Kasi sa manual, this is, you're going to drop this in a very different form with the use of a metric scale. And a metric scale is a must when you're going to drop this on a manual basis. So, if you're ready, let us start with our tutorial. Here, our foundation plan na ginawa natin dati. Now, karamihan sa mga nagawa-gawang mga foundation plan, I mean footing column detail, they are using dynamic blocks. Now, what if we are going to start from scratch, especially sa mga high school students because they have less ideas on how to have dynamic blocks sa pag-draft ng mga footing column details and even wall footing. So, this is the steps. Okay? So, the first thing you have to do is you are going to copy your footing column. So, if isa lang naman ang footing column natin, so there's no need for you to have a dual detail kasi nag-iisa lang naman ang footing column natin dito. So, I'm going to copy this one outside and then I'm going to set the layer into common layer. Now, remember, before we proceed, I'd like to stress these things out. If there are two, if a one-story lang ang bahay na bungalow ba, the size of a footing this is the footing and this is the column. So footing starts at 1.1 meter. And then it is submerged pababa at least 1 meter pababa. Okay, after ng 1 meter galing sa grade line pababa and then starts the footing. So that is the deep that you are going to have. But if two floors, it ranges from 1.5 going downwards. Okay? And then the footing size that has for two floors is at least at 1.20 to 1.5. Yun ang mga standards. Now, for column, sa isang one floor lang naman, it ranges from 0.20 or 20 centimeter. And then if you have two floors, it ranges from 30 centimeter to 40 centimeter. Okay, so let us start with our work. So, kailangan muna natin ang ating plan. So, the first thing you're going to concentrate is inside. Okay, so it's we are going to drop this from scratch, okay? So I'm going to have an offset of 0.025 or 1 inch going inside. So after this one, I'm going to have circle of 0.01. So i-move ko tong drawing na to ang center, and then copy this one on the opposite side, and then repeat the same process. Copy naman natin siya sa baba, but we have still to move this drawing. So move ko lang to siya, let's type M, move, and then I'm going to move this one. And then same procedure, move, going inside, and move, going inside. Same procedure will be doing here. You have to move the objects, and then move these two, going inside. And then, now, after that, you already have this one, no? I-explode ko to siya. And then I'm going to offset this one at 0.01. Okay. Then I'm going to trim these edges here. On four corners. Now after that you have trimmed this one, mag-offset ako ng 0.01 for all these circles. As represented na circular ang bending ng mga lateral ties. So, lahat ito i-describe pa natin mamaya, isa-isa. Okay, so, if you are already working with AutoCAD, at least you are already very versatile with trimming with the lines that are unnecessary. So, trim natin ito siya, and then, I'm going to trim this one here. So, trim natin ito, mga corners na hindi kailangan, so that it would represent. So if ever na erase, you just place it another one. Okay, sama lahat ng pag-trim. Okay, so I'm going to give this copy here. Pumataas. Okay, now, after that, you are going to have it here. I'm going to make a line here at least at 0.05 ang distance. And then I'm going to offset this one at 0.01. Then create a line here, as this is represented as the lateral ties that are bent follow-up. Okay, so I'm going to rotate this one at 45 degree, tab 45, enter, and then I'm going to rotate this drawing or mirror na lang. Okay, rotate, it would also be the same, and then I'm going to move this one somewhere here, eto dito, and then the other one will be moved or copied dito. Then, extend this one, trim, and then this one will be trim. So, as this is represented that this is a bent bar. So, I'm going to layer right away itong apat na, itong drawing na ginawa ko sa loob, as represented as the vertical and lateral ties. So, I'm going to give this as wall, and then, ito naman, I'm going to layer this one into fine lines. Fine lines, ito siya. Now, after that, you're going to have it, I'm going to offset this one at 0.025 again. Or pwede naman 0.05. Then, I'm going to explode this one. Okay, explode. And then, you're going to divide this into 0.16. So, in other words, into 6. So, remember, for one horizontal, for one-story residential, at least 6 deformed bars ang kailangan. For two-story, at least 8. Minimum yan po ah. So, offset by 0.18. Okay. So, explode muna natin. Explode, offset by 0.18. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, in other words, that is 6. Same procedure, pataas. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5, 6. Okay. So, trim the unnecessary lines that are not needed in your drawing. Okay, so after that we already placed this as the four bars dito, we're going also to detail this one. So offset natin siya ng 0.01 two times, 1, 2, 3, and then I'm going to create fillet. Now remember, you are drawing this from scratch, so 0.05 kasi kapag gumagamit na tayo, especially sa mga high schools, they do not know yet the process of creating dynamic blocks. Although these are, can be applied right away, pero if you're going to do this from scratch, at least you have the idea. So, mirror natin siya. Then, yes. And then, this object must be placed sa opposite side. Okay. So, now that you already have this two, no? You are going to copy this one on all these sides na meron tayo. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then yung opposite, well, I'm going to reverse this one, and I'm going to mirror this one. Away. Yes. Okay, and then move this drawing somewhere here. Okay, now, after that you're done, I'm just going to copy this drawing that I created. Copy, and then I'm going to rotate this into vertical mode. So in other words, para hindi na tayo masyado mag-draw from scratch lahat, you just have to copy all the objects that you created. So, place it on the distance of the bars that you created. Okay? And then, same procedure. Mirror. Click. Click, and then click yes. And then, move again the object dito. Okay, now, after that, you're going down here, no, you're done. I'm going to erase this one. So in other words, this is a deformed bars. Now, I'm going to fast track here and I'm going to trim all the unnecessary lines para malinis tignan ng ating output. Okay? So I'm going to fast track here and then I'm going to trim. So, now we are done with the trimming of all the edges that are not important. Always remember, so importante talaga malinis ang ating trabaho. Okay, so try to check if you miss some, at least madali nyong ma-recover ang inyong output. So, importante, malinis ang ating output. Okay, so if ever you miss some, you just have to trim it so that malinis ang ating mga output. And then, it will be more presentable. Now that we already have this one, no, we are going to draft also with the use of, syempre, the projection method. So this is what we call an isolated footing. There are so many kinds of footings that are available na pwede nating design. We have cantilever, we have continuous footing, okay? We have the group footing and so on and so forth, okay? So, yun ang ating kailangan tandaan. So, offset natin ito siya ng 1 meter. Remember, the distance of coming from the grade line to the footing sa lower, at least as 1 meter. And then, mag-offset tayo ng 0.30 pababa para sa ating footing. And then, copy this drawing here to here. And then, I'm going to offset at this 0.1 for the gravel bed sa baba. Okay. So, meron pang gravel bed. So, dito, I'm going to proceed copying this one. Okay. So, copy the opposite side. Then, if you wish to trim this one here, somewhere here, you may do trimming it. Then I'm going to place your brake line coming dito brake line, click enter. Okay, sorry, brake line, click on the left, click on the right, and then on the center. Okay, so sa taglit lang ha, I'll continue with brake line afterwards, and then I'm going to proceed muna yung importante. So click lang dito siya, and then this one. Okay, so going to create lines, not necessarily kailangan na measured siya. Okay, and then going to trim this one. Okay. Okay, later na lang. Okay, so I'm going to continue muna for our detail of this routine. Okay, so simple as this, copy, same procedure. So offset ng 0.05, offset ng 0.05 galing dito, then on all corners 0.05, and then trim the unnecessary lines. Okay, so click, and then offset ng 0.01. After that you're done, I'm going to create circles here. Okay. Before I proceed, I'm going to copy this one. Copy. Para sa ating bars. Okay, so fillet. I'm going to fillet that too. Okay, so I'm going to rotate this one, then copy on the first point, ito, trim, then copy this one, here, and then after here, mirror, yes, and then move this object somewhere here at the edge. Okay, so now that you already have this tool, copy na lang natin, imamatch na lang muna natin para matapos na natin siya. Then I'm going to copy this one, these circles into 0.18. Copy at 0.18, then same procedure at 0.18. Okay, again, another 0.18. Then, ito naman at 0.18. Okay. Now that we have already this one, okay, it's time for us. So, going to place lines muna dito. And then, I'm going to offset this one. I mean, copy this one, this line here. Here. Okay, so then extend this one. Copy. On all sides. Now, extending here. And then I'm going to give it an offset of 0.2 para sa bend ng parts natin. So, click lang natin siya punta rito, and then click naman ito punta rito. Trim the unnecessary lines. extend. Okay. Trim. And then, extend naman ito siya. Trim to. And trim. Trim. So, offset ng 0.01. Kita. Dito. Ng 0.01 pa ulit kasi the distance of this is at 0.2. Okay, erase, extend. Remember ha, you are drafting this from scratch. Okay. So after that you are done here, it's time for us to draft the lateral ties. Okay, so here I'm going to click here sa baba. So I'm going to type the offset 0.05. Then you're going to create lines like this. Okay, so you're going to 0.01 for the lateral ties. And then let's try to check kung hanggang saan using projection method. Okay, erase this one. Then, click line. Kung ba kung saan siya tatama. Line. And then, going downwards. Same procedure. Line. And then, you are going to take the distance of 0.05. Okay. So, trim. Pwede rin naman, if you're going to offset this one, fillet this one, you do so. Okay? F. Pwede rin naman. Okay, so, I'm going to trim this one here, and I'm going to hatch these lines inside. So, I'm going to hatch this one, okay, into solid. Then, after here, meron siyang distance. Now, before, meron tayong 3 of 0.05, 3 of 0.15, 3 of 0.10, and 3 of 0.15, and then the rest of 0.20. Pwede rin naman siyang ganun. Okay, so, meron namang mga bago, 2 of 0.05, 3 of 0.75, 5 of 0.15, and then the rest of 0.20. So, depende kung ano ang distance ng preferred ninyo. Pero, I'm going to apply yung ginagamit namin dati. Okay? So, from here, I'm going to copy this 0.05. And then, 3.05, no? Copy. 0.05. Then, after here, I'm going to give it a copy also of 3.15. Of 0.1. 1. 0.1. Or pwede namang copy, or, and then 0.2. Okay, then after that dito, I'm going to give it copy of 0.15, 0.35, 0.3, 0.45. And then the rest at 0.20. So, copy natin siya. Pataas na 0.2. And then, dito, ika-copy ko na lang siya. Copy. Here, coming sa distance dito, copy, pataas, hanggang matapos natin. Okay, so on and so forth. Okay, so until to the rest, last stop ng ating foundation. So not necessarily kailangan lahat talaga siya. Ha? So after nito, we are already done. So let's try to layer our output. Okay. I'm going to give this as wall line and then this one as five lines because our concentration here is the bars, steel bars ng ating object. So, trim, rec, back. So, copy, match everything. Okay, match again. Okay, this one, and so on. So, ito naman, I'm going to layer this one as one line. Remember, you have to scale this para mas clear and detailed. Remember, detailed drawings are scaled up and then it ranges from scale of 1 to 20, 1 to 30, and 1 to 10. Pero depende kung paano siya i-display, i-illustrate. Okay, I'm going to use this as what we call grid line. Okay, grade. We don't have grade line here. We have grade line here. And then I'm going to layer this as section. Okay, now I'm going to hatch this one. Ito dito as soil. Okay, so earth. So let's try to look for earth symbol. And then I'm going to click here and click here. So I'm going to adjust the scale at 0.75. And then I'm going to rotate the angle into 45. So if you want, you can lower the scale by 0.5. Pwede. Okay, so ito, I'm going to layer this as section, as the thinnest line. Dito naman, hatch natin siya as the gravel bed. So I'm going to indicate gravel. Click. Now you can adjust the scale, 0.2 ba? Or 0.15. So, I'm going to layer this one as section. Okay. Now, if you wish to add concrete layer, pwedeng-pwede, you can do so. Okay? Okay. So, now that we are done editing everything here, it's time for us to scale our drawing. So, remember, detailed drawing usually ranges from scale of 1 to 20, 1 to 25, 1 to 30, 1 to 10, 1 to 5. Pero ideally, for foundation plan or footing column, they are ranges from 1 to 20. So, simply, from what we have learned from ating sa previous drawings natin, okay, you are going to scale your drawing into 1 to 20. So, remember, hindi pa tayo nag-dimension, ha? So, I'm going to highlight this one, scale, okay? Or even if you want, you can already indicate the text here. So, for example, copy natin to siya, copy, F8, so this is the plan. I'm going to name this as plan. And then move on drawing. Copy. Ito naman ang section. Okay? So section. And move this drawing going center. Now, if you're already done with editing, just not make sure lang ha, hindi pa tayo nakapag-dimension. Kasi iba ang scale ng dimension natin. So, I'm going to scale this drawing into specify base point and then I'm going to type 100/20. Which means our drawing becomes much more bigger. Okay, now, if you're using DWG units, mas maganda rin yun siya. Okay, kasi hindi na natin kailangan mag-set up ng scale. All you have to do is just only to change yung scaling dito. But if you did not use one DWG units, pwede natin siyang i-edit ang scale natin. So, D, let's change our scale. Since wala tayong 1 to 20, no? I'm going to click new, and then I'm going to 1/20 MTRS. And then continue. So, dito, the first thing you have to edit here is the scale factor. I'm going to type here 0.20. 0.2 is the same. Okay, so, after dito, that we already had, you're going to increase the text size. So in other words, so if this one is to 20, I'm going to edit this into 0.3, 0.35 pwede. And then okay, and then the line symbol should at least be 0.40 or 0.45. Pwede din. So 0.40 would be enough. Okay, and then the rest keep it as it is. So okay. So after dito, if you're already done editing here, and I'm going to click 1:20, and then I'm going to set current and then close. So it's time for us to finalize our drawing by placing dimension. So DLI. Okay, I'm going to change my dimension layer, DLI, click natin siya, click, and then you already have your dimensions. Okay, click, click, you already have your dimensions para dito. Okay, so 0.20, the rest, same procedure. Dito, kailangan nyo na lang mag-adjust ng ating drawings. Okay, so, adjust lang natin ng konti so that it would be proportion as it is. So, click lang, click. Okay, so, here, I'm going to adjust this one, place it outside, para hindi siya masyadong, it will be more understandable to look at your output. Okay, dito lang, let's say procedure, ito naman, dito lang. Now, dito naman, sa kabila, I'm going to do the same procedure, DLI, pupunta dito, 1 meter, remember, and then dimension continue, at this at 0.3, and then, dito naman, gravel bed natin at 0.1. Okay, so, therefore, we are already almost done tayo sa output natin. Then, it's time for us to use multi-liter line. So, MLD. Okay, click natin to siya. Okay, text. I'm going to change text. MLD. So, by description, click. I'm going to give this as, remember, for full footing column, the ideal is 16 millimeter diameter steel bar. So, of course, for 10% C diameter steel bars. Okay, so dito, it would be 6 of 16 millimeter steel bars for our description. Okay, after that you place a 16 diameter steel bar, and then I'm going to give this as I'm going to create circle here. Okay. Okay, say for example 0.15, and then I'm going to type MLD dito. Okay, click, and then I'm going to give this as 4 of 16 millimeter %% C diameter steel bars, or what we call vertical steel bars. Then, if you still have this one here, okay, we have 10 millimeter %% C lateral ties. Okay, so we already have this description. Ayan naman dito, I'm going to give this as dito naman. So copy ko na lang to. Okay, copy ko na lang to. Copy. Place it here sa baba for your description. So dito, I'm going to type this, same procedure, 8 millimeter, 6 of 16 diameter steel bars, and then I'm going to give you ML. Okay, now also, do not forget to add, kasi karamihan, constant talaga sa atin ang both ways here. So, 16 steel bars, you can still add here both ways. Okay? And then, dito naman, you can add here 16 millimeters steel bars both ways. So, let's check kung ano pang na-miss natin. So, remember, you have to indicate here. So, copy ko na lang ito siya. F8. And I'm going to reduce the stack size here. Okay, I'm going to reduce this in 2.5. And I'm going to type here NGL. Presented as this is the green. Okay, so if you also want to add here, copy. This is gravel bed. Okay, so gravel bed at 0.10 meters. Okay, so what else did you forget? This one, if you want 4 of 16, copy na lang natin siya, and then place it somewhere here, and then adjust. Okay, so in other words, we are almost done with our work. Of course, if you add more details, it would be much better if you add more details on your work. Okay, so it's time for us to plot. Let's try to use A3. Okay. So A3, I'm going to erase this existing viewport, and then I'm going to type here viewport para sa ating plot. Okay. So single. Okay. Click lang natin siya dito to the middle. So I'm going to look first for my foundation plans. For example, ito muna ang online ko. So I'll be moving this one. I'll move this one on the side. Itong i-concentrate ko. So after dito, remember, 10:1 is the most ideal here. So, foundation plan. And then ilalagay naman natin dito sa kabila ang isa pang viewport. Okay. Single. Click. Click. And hanapin natin ang ating drawing. So 10:1. Dito sa kabila ang ating section. But we did not yet indicate the drawing that you're going to have. It's very important. So I'm going to copy this one. Copy. So if you want to lesser the scale of the text kasi masyadong malaki, pwede. Just try to make it proportion. So move dito. And then I'm going to give this title of footing dash column. And then extend here, and then I'm going to change the scale into 1:20 meters. Move it a little bit further, and then place the item of the drawing centered. Okay, so let's try to check it on our A3 size. So this is our output for foundation plan. All you have to do is just to change this one into foundation plan details. Foundation plan. Plan. Then slash footing or FC details. So, if you are already done with your output, you can plan this one. Okay, so this is how you're going to draft footing column if wala tayong dynamic blocks. So in other words, you are going to drop this from scratch. Especially this is intended for high school, senior high school students who does not have yet the extensive idea on using AutoCAD sa kanilang work. So, pero sa basic purposes, you may do so itong output na ito. This video will serve as a guide for you for your activity. This is Coach Gene of Drafting Lifestyle, and hanggang sa susunod na tutorial, ang ituturo ko naman sa inyo ay ang wall footing details.